Hey Drew, how are you today?
Hey Hadley, I'm good. How you doing?
Good. Thanks for joining me. I know you've been able to watch some of the other videos that I've done with Calypsonians. So I was hoping that today you and I could talk about advanced analytics. Can you tell me a little bit more about what's behind this renewed interest in analytics?
Yeah, I think, you know, the retail industry has a history of being really mature in analytics capabilities, but for far too long, I think that analytics capability has been focused on the consumer and not on the product. We're starting to see that change. So we're seeing product leaders saying, you know, they're really wanting to turn that investment and focus it on product as a strategic priority and investment this year.
Yeah, that's interesting. So what kinds of analytics capabilities specifically are you seeing these product leaders investing in?
We really coach our clients to focus on prioritizing a handful of high value use cases across the product lifecycle. So for example, in the discover phase, you know, a merchant team might use a predictive analytics model to look over a decade of product sales history and provide recommendations on how to optimize their line plan, you know, allowing them to sort of focus on those fewer, better products. Or, you know, during the creative process, a designer might use a machine learning model to make predictions or prescriptions about the kind of material that they should be using for their product out of an enormous material library that they couldn't possibly sift through on their own. You know, on the factory floor, even, you know, there's an opportunity to use smart connected operations and simulation data to optimize the efficiency of their workforces there, to reduce material handling and cost from labor, which is a really significant driver of cost in the retail industry. And before doing any of that, really, you know, there's an opportunity to integrate voice of consumer preference and price sensitivity testing, which really allows product leaders to make decisions with less risk.
Wow, yeah, sounds really great. But if it were easy, everyone would be doing it, right? So is it that it's tripping people up? What do we see most?
Yeah, I think that there's probably three lessons that we can take away from those who are leading in this space. The first and probably most important is to have a bias for delivering value quickly. Unlike a lot of other technologies, you know, enterprise solutions, advanced analytics programs don't require a long lead time or significant capital investment to get up and running and start delivering value. My second tip would be to use analytics translators, people who are experts in understanding the strategic and operational needs of the business and who can translate those into the kinds of challenges that data scientists can really sink their teeth into. Along with that is the need to recognize the challenge in operationalizing those new analytics capabilities. It's really not enough just to provide the insight and hope that the organization is going to respond accordingly. You have to be prepared to combat the natural skepticism and resistance and fear that exists when artificial intelligence and machine learning is introduced into organizations, and help people to understand that these models are not like, you know, a cyborg Terminator as much as they are the kind of augmented enhancement that Iron Man has.
Yeah. Any last thoughts, Drew, that you'd share with those product leaders out there that are just looking to get started?
Yeah, I think I would encourage people to start small, move fast, and focus on how their program can deliver impact fast. The reality is that there's a mountain of product and supply chain data within their organizations right at their fingertips. It's begging to be put to work for the organization. And I think that they can stand up the capability to deliver a self-funding analytics program in a matter of weeks instead of months. So, you know, why not get started?
Yeah, why not? Sounds compelling to me. Thanks, Drew, for all your time and your thoughts today. This was really helpful.
You bet. Thanks, Hadley.
Thank you. Bye.